What's going on, everybody? 5280 Reefer here. And I know this is a long overdue update. And I mean long. But hey, what can you do? Life throws you curveballs. Had a kid about 3 weeks ago. He's 3 weeks old now. First kid, so that's been most of my time is my kid, appointments, stuff like that. But I'm going to try to get back on track and start doing weekly videos for you guys with just updates, maybe some additions, things like that. I don't promise that they're going to be very long videos, but I'm going to try to keep them short and sweet. Except this one. This one's going to be kind of long. So, everything that's happened to this tank ever since I set it up and started the cycle, started with live, I mean, dry rock, dry sand, nothing special. Just went forward with it. Took about 2 months before I even added any fish into the tank. First inhabitants were the two Randall's gobies that you guys will see some more in this video. Then I got the yellow wrasse. He was about an inch when I first got him. He was a tiny guy. Then I picked up my purple tang, my naso, and my fox face at the same time. And also algae plenty. And that's pretty much it for livestock. I threw in two cleaner shrimp. I threw in two tiger conches, bunch of hermits, and I think like five trochus snails, and about seven pincushion urchins. They do a good job for the most part. Let's see. At one point, I decided to make myself an overflow cover. I used Krylon Fusion to paint a piece of acrylic. Kind of dumb of me. Yes, Krylon Fusion is good for outside of aquariums, but nothing that's going to actually touch water. So it actually started leaching lead into my water. So some of my tester corals that I picked up and threw into the tank after the initial cycle and, parameters stabilized, they just died. So I didn't do any ICP testing. I kind of just backtracked and figured out that that was my issue. So I ended up picking up some Two Little Fishies Cuprazorb, or Metazorb, I mean. Threw in there for about 7 days and took it out. Put some more Testa corals in there. They did great. So I was like, all right, perfect. So I know what I did wrong. I added about 10 pounds of Miracle Mud into the sump. That's why you see really good polyp extension on my LPS and my SPS. I do have some GHA here and there, but it's small patches, and if anything, if it gets annoying, I just remove it once a week, which probably actually happens once a month, because it's not too bad. Other than that, since that, this tank has been smooth sailing. Parameters, pH stays around 8.3 to 8.5, temperatures between 77 and 79, alkalinity is always at 8.8 because of the apex dose, calcium's always at 410, magnesium's at about 1450, 1400, somewhere around there. I don't often check it. Let's see. Calcium is being dosed at about 37 mils a day, same with alkalinity. Nitrates are about 15 to 20 ppm. Phosphates are between 0.04 to 0.1 ppm, and that's perfect. I love it. And I am experimenting with a new lens I got for the camera, so I'm not a professional in any way, guys, but I'll try to get better as time goes. I need to get a better tripod. The $10 one I have isn't, it's not cutting, it's all shaky. And you can't twist it and turn it in certain ways, which kind of makes me have to pick up the camera and hold it in my hand, and it's just annoying. But for coral, let's see. I've got a bunch of SPS. I've got ORA Red Planet. I've got Tyree's Pinky the Bear. I got PC Rainbow. I got UC Shortcake, which is the small little stub you guys just saw on the left side. This is actually Tyree Pinky the Bear. I got him damaged, but it's doing a lot. lot better. It's got really good polyp extension. And hey, there goes one of the gobies. I have Walt Disney. I have a Passiflora. I have a purple Stylophora. I have that Gorg back there to the right. This one right here. I got that damaged as well. I got it for free. But it is coming back. It is filling up all the dead spots because it was right next to an enemy in one of my friend's tanks. So it's coming back to life. It's looking good. I got some GSP, got a few A cans, got some Zoas, some Fruit Loops, some Seductions. That SPS right there, that's actually TCK Pikachu. Small little frag, just waiting for it to grow and color up some more. Got a Gani. Let's see, Green Slimer. Got the WWC Grafted Monty, which you guys saw a little clip of earlier. I got a Jason Fox Fox Flame. That was that tiny nub way earlier in the video. I got it. It was completely brown, and it's now starting to get reds and greens and many different colors. So it's awesome. Got a Space Invader Pectina. And I do plan on getting more things because the tank is pretty much still pretty bare. But I think we have a lot of time to do that. So, and I'll make sure to keep you guys updated from here on out with all the new additions. Do some faraway shots, some macro shots, and I tried to do some shots from the side of the tank, but the gyres are in the way, and it's a little annoying because if you tilt the lens kind of not exactly flat with the glass, it warps and messes up the shot completely, and I hate it, and it doesn't look good at all. So I'll figure something out. But yeah, so here was the sh here is the Walt Disney. Still has a lot of coloring up to do, but has some really good polyp extension, and I know it's going to get more and more as it grows. It is healing and getting used to my water. That's the ORA Red Planet. It looks more red in real life than it does in this video, but it's still, I think, one of the best looking SPS you can get. It's just beautiful. It's got a lot more polyp extension than when I first got it. It has more in this tank than it did in the other fella's tank. But yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Join back in for new videos. I'll try to get some more live stuff going. So yeah, like, share, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys.